We are people of faith, faith in each other, faith in the ability of our church to make a difference, faith that our common humanity can sing in harmony so the threads of the great web resonates with joyful life, faith in a loving and compassionate God working through us, who can only work through us to make the world a better place. So welcome to our worship. Nothing is lost to the heart of God. Nothing is lost forever. God's heart is love, and that love will remain, holding the world forever. No impulse of love, no office of care. No moment of life in all its fullness. No beginning too late, no ending too soon, but is gathered and known in its goodness.
Reading from Genesis chapter 2. At the time when God made the heavens and the earth, there was still no wild bush on the earth, nor had any wild plant sprung up. For God had not yet sent rain to the earth, and there was no human being to till the soil. Instead, a flow of water would well up from the ground and irrigate the soil. So God fashioned an earth creature out of the clay of the earth and blew into its nostrils the breath of life, and the earth creature became a living being. God planted a garden to the east in Eden, land of pleasure, and placed in it the earth creature that had been made. Then God caused every kind of tree, enticing to look at and good to eat, to spring from the soil. In the centre of the garden was the tree of life and the tree of knowledge of good and evil. A river flows through Eden to water the garden, after which it branches into four tributaries. Then God took the earth creature and settled it in the Garden of Eden so that it might cultivate and care for the land. Then God said, "It is not good for the earth creature to be alone. I will make a fitting companion for it." So from the soil, God formed all the various wild beasts and all the birds of the air and brought them to the earth creature to be named. Whatever the earth creature called each one, that became its name. The earth creature gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals. May we be struck by the wisdom of these words and marked by hearing them. For within story lies meaning, and within meaning, the wisdom for which we seek.
Thank you. One of the old stories at the beginning of Genesis tells us that God's first act after completing creation was to plant a garden, the Garden of Eden. And then in the first sighting of Jesus after the resurrection, he's mistaken by Mary Magdalene for the gardener, because that is precisely what he is, the gardener of the new creation. We read about the life, death, and resurrection of Christ in the Bible, but in the garden, we experience it. Every time we plant a tiny, misshapen seed and watch it burst into life from its earthy tomb, it is as though we have seen the Easter story reenacted. Early Celtic Christians were very aware of this. 3 days before sowing, farmers were sprinkling the seed with water in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. If possible, they would plant on a Friday. The moistening hastened the seed's growth, and planting on Friday was always a reminder of Christ's death and burial. Planting was always symbolic of the planting of Christ, the seed of the new world from which resurrection life will come for all humankind, as well as creation. Donna Shaper, the senior minister at Judson Memorial Church on Washington Square in New York City, once wrote this: "Gardens have been the ground which has rooted me as a citizen of the globe. I have loved all kinds of dirt in all kinds of places, and in each place I have improved the soil. Gardening is a landed, dirty ritual that sustains hope for the new, which is another way of saying gardens sustain activists. Gardening is a good grounding activity that keeps us humble and open to the mysteries and miracles of growth, transformation, and radical change. I'm sure you, like me, can reminisce about the many gardens we have tended over the years in different places. For those who have got down on their hands and knees to tend the good earth, we are reminded of plenty of cogent insights into planning a garden, moving through the seasons, mulch, weeding, seeds, and compost. Along the way, we will also recall our backs seizing up by overdoing it and learning the lessons that the soil can teach the soul about hope, possibility, renewal, balance, and change. Of course, gardening is also about play, attention, openness, and patience. Gardening almost brings its own rituals too. We go beyond just working the soil, toiling mightily, head down. Do we ever leave without a good look around? Without taking the opportunity to be? Or think how often we are in the garden but not working it, just enjoying it, even though the temptation just to pull up another weed is always there. Stopping long enough to see the growth and how things have changed, usually since a few days before. learning to see change is important for both all of us gardeners and non-gardeners alike. Otherwise, we think nothing is happening, when all the while nature quietly goes on living. Here's how one writer described their experience. In the process of caring for and admiring my tulips, I encountered the spiritual dimension of gardening. One Sunday late afternoon, as I walked past the tulips, I was drawn to one tulip in particular. The tulip's pink petals were wide open. The inside of the delicate tulip revealed the exquisite intricacy of the tulip's black and soft yellow stamen and a brighter yellow pistil. I was overcome with awe and wonder. Something so beautiful could not be designed by human hands. An overwhelming sense of peace came over me. This moment was a God experience. The writer went on, the next morning the tulips were tightly closed and asleep. Their petals were sprinkled with droplets of morning dew. Simply magical. My success with the tulips and my God experience with them planted the seed for my growing love of gardening. Little by little, I planted more gardens and more kinds of flowers. As Donna Shaper said, gardens and gardening also stimulate people into activism, inspired by the spirituality of being close to the earth. Think, for example, of food cooperatives like FarmShare, a network of small-scale, sustainable food-growing projects. Their vision is to support food systems that educate, connect, and empower local communities to be healthier and more resilient, to be rooted to the land and to each other, and to experience a direct relationship with how our food is produced. Through that, our opportunities for learning about ecologically sensitive farming methods, enjoying and celebrating local seasonal food, and sharing knowledge and expertise. Some farm share projects receive and deliver nationally tons of vegetables considered too ugly for supermarkets. One of them, started by a woman going through a difficult divorce, at the suggestion of a grower who wanted to get rid of the high fees that he was paying in waste collection, FarmShare now supplies soup kitchens around the country. Imagine the pressure on a tomato or a squash. It must look perfect to go to market. Just like many of us must look better than we do in order to go to the shops ourselves.
We light this candle in remembrance and hope, to call to mind Magnus and Ronald and all the saints, and all those dear to us who have gone before, especially those who have died in recent times, and as a sign of hope to future generations as yet unborn, Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life."
Senses stimulated, sights to delight in and dream about, sensual and evocative, or more earthy, smells that bind us with creation, textures and tastes, both familiar and rediscovered. Birdsong echoing our inner response to a walk or seat in a garden. The spirit desires us to enjoy the beauty of creation in our gardens, allotments, and window boxes, parks and roadsides, wild and tended. Yet there is soil to be turned over, manure to be dug in, and seeds to be sown. Flowers need watering and grass cutting, hedges trimming and trees pruning. A garden needs planting, tending, and love. A gift to be worked at, to be worked with, as well as enjoyed. A living thing to invest in, as well as to treasure. We give thanks for gardens, small and large, local and global. May we delight in them, respect them, enjoy sharing them and their fruit with neighbours and creatures, great and small. Amen.
To God the Father, glory be to God.
Walk bravely, facing the truth, with goodness in your heart and beauty in your actions. May you stay safe in the way of Christ, and may you be blessed by his Spirit this day and always. Amen.